Focus at work. It can be really, really difficult, and something that apps can help us and help us to fine-tune our attention into whatever we're working on at hand. Today, I've picked out 5 focus applications that I think will be useful for your work day. So before we begin, we've just launched a brand new course called the Bento Methodology Course, helping you to focus using our traditional Bento methodology, which we created, and you can check it out, the link in the description. There's also a companion application, which has been growing really popular for iPhone users and iPad users below. So obviously there's so many different focus apps on the market. The first one I wanna start with is a music one. Now, a lot of people tend not to work with music and some actually aren't allowed, but I love working with music and I think that instrumental music can be really beneficial, instrumental to your working routine. There's an app called Endl, and it's a really interesting take on the music for productivity, because what it does is it uses a variety of inputs, and anything from the weather outside to the circadian rhythm of our daily routines and how our bodies are working, like our resting heart rate, etc. And it creates a soundscape for you that basically is designed suitable for all of those inputs. And it's really interesting how effective it actually is. I use on a daily routine when I'm trying to do writing in particular, the deeper focus soundscape, which is really nice. And for bedtime, I use their sleep soundscape, which I really like as well. And apparently it only gets better once you've got an Apple Watch too, because it helps to monitor all of those different health markers and improve your soundscape to that. So very cool combination of science and technology right there. And it's definitely a great way to help tune in and really to focus and set yourself a nice timer there. The second app I want to mention is FUTHER. Now, FUTHER has been on the market for some time and many of you probably know it already. It essentially is an app for iPhone and Android. They're basically, when you start a forest, you start growing a forest and it will set a timer for it. And if you interrupt that process, go onto another app, take a call, basically what it will do is it will kill that tree. It's essentially helping you to stop using your phone during work. So if that's something that you're quite persistent on and something that always tends to distract you, then using FUTHER is a great way to do that, because you build a forest each time, and the goal is to build that healthy habit and have a really bustling forest with lots of trees and greenery. So I'd recommend checking it out, and it's of a low price as well too. Number 3 is balance. Now, obviously one element of focus in your day is having that marathon, not a sprint approach. And the best way to do that is to be a bit more mindful and look at how you're spending your breaks. Balance is a great app for that. It's available on Android and iPhone as well. But basically what it does is it helps you do short meditations. I believe the first year is actually free. I got that when the pandemic started, and it's been fantastic. But they do things like the midday reset and other smaller 5-minute sessions. And the guy who does the voice, Afusu, his voice is really relaxing and very compelling. I've got a voice crush on him, clearly. And I think their little micro meditations are really nice. A nice addition to your day, taking that marathon or the sprint approach. Number 4 is Freedom. Now, this is something to install over on your laptop and is an app that helps to block websites. If you're someone that is writing or doing a bit of research or thesis or something like that takes you offline to really focus, then the best way to distract yourself, is to take yourself away from those temptations. And Freedom actually blocks sites that you set for a set period of time, locking yourself out of them. And it's a really cool addition to your Mac or your other devices as well. Number 5 is Session. Now, the Pomodoro technique is a really effective one. 25 minute timer with a 5-minute break, and you can do up to 4 cycles of that. But there's an app that really optimizes it and looks stunning. It's called Session, and it's a great independently developed application, essentially helping you create little timers and to start making notes as you go through as well on how well your sessions did. But the real benefit, if you go on the pro plan, is the analytics that they produced. It's really impressive. You can see reports of how productive you were over a period, and you can feedback yourself as well, like were you focused during those sessions, and learn as you go from those analytics. So highly recommend Session, a really beautifully designed application in my opinion. So that was all of the five apps for focusing. Obviously, taking yourself away from apps is sometimes a good and effective way to focus. So that's also an alternative. Obviously, apps aren't the answer to everything, even though we have a channel based on reviewing apps. But I want to give you the best advice. Some of the best and most sort of focus times I do is when I take myself away with a pen and paper or with my Remarkable and just separate myself from proper technology that is connected to the internet and take myself away and don't give myself that optionality. Anyway, folks, the Bento methodology course is available below. It's been an absolute pleasure, and feel free to share this video if you think there are apps that you and your friends might find value from, or your community will find value from too. Thank you very much, folks. Feel free to share in the comments any apps that you find useful below too. I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio.